Hello children, this was 7th standard science, unit 4. The name of the lesson is Cell Biology, which is in page number 57. First we will see the learning objectives. To compare the plant cell with animal cell and understand the similarities and dissimilarities. To understand the cell as a fundamental unit of life. To know and understand the different types of human cells and their related functions. To know the functions of different cell organelles, to compare different cell organelles and their functions and know their similarities and specialities. So first we'll see the introduction part. So if you take Earth, we are calling it as living planet. Why we are calling Earth as a living planet? Living things can exist only on the Earth. If you take the things which are living on the Earth, human beings, plants, animals are there. Yes? So the commonly we can divide the things as living things and non-living things. So what are all the characteristic features of living things means? Living things can move from one place to another place except plants, and living things can breathe, living things can grow, isn't it? So how these things are happening? Why these things are not happening on living things, non-living things means? There is a special thing, that is how matter is. If you take matter composed of atoms and molecules, like that organism is human beings, plants, animals, everything in their body, they are having cell. Cell is the fundamental unit of organism. So our Earth is a beautiful place wherein different types of organisms happily coexist, from minute mosses to huge conifers. That is, the size is minute mosses to huge conifers, invisible bacteria to huge blue whale, and all have a basic unit called cell. Now we'll study about the cell. Okay children, so cell has, so if you see this picture, the building wall is made up of numerous bricks. In the similar manner, a beehive is composed of numerous hexagonal units. So some of the organisms are represented by a single cell. So therefore, they show a simple organization. So the basic fundamental unit of an organism is called a cell. So the structure of a cell represents the arrangement of parts of organelles in a cell. So function is the activity of each part or organelle in a cell. If you take one cell, inside the cell, cell organelles will be present, and that cell organelles, each and every cell organelles is having their own function. Yes, the so function of the cell is carried out by each and every cell organelles present in the cell. So cells are the basic building blocks of an organism. Is already have learned that the atoms are the basic building blocks of matter, isn't it? So in matter lesson, chemistry lesson, we have studied atoms and molecules are the building blocks of matter. Like that living organisms, in living organisms, cell plays an important role. Cell is the fundamental unit of an organism. So based on the number of cell present in an organism, it is classified into two types: unicellular organism and multicellular organisms. The word uni means one, multi means many. So here one example is given: Chlamydomonas and amoeba. Yes, in the picture is given below, amoeba and Chlamydomonas. So in this organism, it will have only one cell. So all the function, yes, the function of all all is carried out only by a single cell, which is having, amoeba and Chlamydomonas is having only one cell. So all the function of this amoeba and Chlamydomonas is taken out by a single cell. For example, respiration, digestion, excretion, everything will be carried out by a single cell. So, and this, if you take again the one more classification is there, we can see the organisms which we can see with the naked eye means we call that as macro organisms, which we cannot see, only we can see one through the microscope means we call that organism as macro organisms. Micro means very 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 small, we can view only through the microscope, we call that organism as micro organisms. Macro organisms means the organisms which we can see with the naked eye, we call that as macroorganisms. So here this unicellular organisms are microscopic in nature. Clear children? So here multicellular organism, the cells are organized into, in multicellular organism there will be number of cells will be present. So these cells are organized to tissues, okay, organs. So tissue, collection of tissues will be present in the organs, collection of organ will be present in the organ system, and it leads to a organisms. Clear children? So macroscopic organisms are visible and consist of many cells. So the body of macroscopic organisms involves various functions. Okay, so if you see this picture, it is given, and the cell of onion and cell of the human tongue is given, you can see that one. Cell to organisms, how organisms formed. So many cells function together to form tissues, and different tissues combine together to form an organ, and different organs to form an organ system, which leads to form an organisms. So if I explain with the example, it will be clear for you. So organisms, many types of organ systems function together in a body. Example, respiratory system, digestive system, excretory system, circulatory system, etc. Many organs together form an organ system, which is considered with a specific function. For example, respiratory system. Example, if you take respiratory system, which has organs like nostrils, nasal chamber, windpipe and lungs, that helps in the process of respiration. Okay children, so in a plant, the root system consists of primary root, secondary root and tertiary root, which does the function of conduction of minerals and water, and also the fixation. So if you take plant, you know the structure of a plant. Okay, the root system is present below the soil, the part which is present above the soil we call it as shoot system. So what are all the function also you would have studied in lower classes. Function of root. Root is used for the fixation into the on the earth. Okay. And what is the function of stem? Stem will absorb, root will absorb water from the earth, and it will allow to pass through the stem. So stem plays stem conduct water from root to each and every part of a plant. And if you take the function of leaf is responsible for the production of food by means of photosynthesis. So like this, in organisms, each and every organ is having specific function, organ together to form a organ system. So what is organ? A collection of different tissues worked together to perform a specific function or functions is called an organ. So human body has different organs. Is human body is having different organs like stomach, eye, heart, lungs, etc. are made up of different type of tissues. Okay, each and every human organ is having different types of tissues. Okay children, so tissues are made up of different type of cells. Like that, plants have also organs such as leaves, stems and roots. So each and every organ is having their own function, which is carried out by the cells. Clear children? The next one, tissue. Tissue is a group of cells organized for a specific function. So tissues have following features, like same shaped cells or different shaped cells to perform a common function. So human and other animals are made up of nervous tissues. Nervous tissues will be present in the nervous system. Epithelial tissues, that will be present on the skin. Connective tissues, that is, if you take our human body, skeleton is covered by means of muscles, isn't it? Skeleton is covered by means of muscles. Muscles will be protected by means of skin. So there must be a connection between bone and the muscle. So that will be, we call that tissue as a connective tissues. And the tissues which are present on the muscles, we call that as a muscle tissues. Clear children? So plants are transport, protective and ground tissues. Yes, like human beings, plant is also having the tissues which are useful for the transportation, protection and ground tissues. So if you observe this picture, so in human body, cell, next one is tissues, next organ, organ system and organism. So like that, plant body, cell, tissue, organ, organ system and organism. Okay children, now we'll see the cell. So cell is a basic structural and functional unit of life. Cell is a building unit of living organisms. So you can see in the hand how many types of cells are there to work together to perform its function means. So first thing I already explained, isn't it? Epithelial cells are present on the skin and bone cells are present inside the bone and muscle cells are present on the muscles and nerves also are present on the nervous system. Clear children? The next one, plant and animal comparison. Now we are going to see the comparison between plant cell and animal cell. So why do plant cells differ from animal cells? They differ from each other because they have to perform different functions. So in man, the cells has to perform different functions. In plant has to perform different function. Isn't it children? Plants has to produce their own food and it has to stand erect and roots has to observe water from the earth and it has to conduct through the stem. So each and every function will be carried out by cell, isn't it? So it must have different types of cell structure. Now we'll see the similarities between the plant cell and the human cell. So human cells related to functions, first we'll see different types of cells. Our body is made up of many different types of cells, many different kinds of cells. So each type of cell is specialized to perform a specific function. So depending on the function, cell has specific shape, size and may have some components which other type of cells do not have. So you can look at the differences between the nerve cells and red blood cells in the images. So even though there are many different types of cells, there are some components common to all type of cells. So that common components alone we'll see now. So what is inside the cells? Inside the cell, what are all the things present? We call that as cell organelles. So inside the cell, there are many tiny structures called cell organelles. And these cells organelles are responsible for providing needs of the cell. So they work to bring in food supplies, get rid of waste, protection and repair of the cell and help it to grow and reproduce. So each one has a specific function to do for the cell. We'll see one by one. Okay children, so here if you take cell structure, as we mentioned before, all the cells have some common structure. Yes, so what are all the common structure means? Three things: cell membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. Cell membrane means the outside covering of the cell, we call it a cell membrane. Then cytoplasm means the space which are present inside the cell membrane, we call that as a cytoplasm. And inside the cytoplasm, nucleus will be present. So based on the presence of nucleus, cells are classified into two things: prokaryotic cell, eukaryotic cell. Prokaryotic cell means the cell which is not having nucleus, we call that as prokaryotic cell. Eukaryotic cell means the cells which are having nucleus in it. So the structure of a typical plant and animal structure shows the following peculiarities. So cell membrane, what is cell membrane? The boundary of an animal cell is the plasma membrane, which is also called as cell membrane, Next one, cell wall. Cell wall will be present only in the plant cell and we call that as a supporter and protector. All animal and plant cells are enclosed or surrounded by a cell membrane. Yes, and here, as you might have noticed previously, that animal cells often have an irregular shape. Whereas plant cells have much more regular and rigid shape. So if you take a structure of a leaf, hibiscus leaf, wherever you are collecting that hibiscus leaf, all the hibiscus leaf will have same size and shape and also the color will also be the same. isn't it children? You are getting hibiscus leaf from your different houses, means all plants, all that leaves, hibiscus leaf will have same color, same size and same structure. This is because of the presence of cell wall. This is due to the presence of cell wall. So plant cells have an additional layer on the outer side of the cell membrane, and this is called as the cell wall. So first difference is plant cell will have cell wall, animal cells do not have cell wall. That is the dissimilarities. Okay children, so this is called as cell wall that provides a framework for support and stability. The cell wall is formed from various compounds. The main one is cellulose, and cellulose helps to maintain the shape of the plant cell. So this allows the plant to remain rigid and upright even if it grows to greater heights. So each cell is interconnected with its neighboring cells through the openings called plasmodesmata, and the picture is given here. Next we'll see they have given one picture, the difference between plant cell and animal cell. First we'll see the plant cell. So if you take the plant cell, it is having cell wall. So what is the function of cell wall? The outermost covering of the plant cell, it maintains the shape and protect the cell. So chloroplast is an organelle characterized by its own two membranes and a high concentration of the chlorophyll to carry out the photosynthesis. So if you see the picture of this plant cell, each and every cell organelle is explained down. So first cell organelle is cell wall. It is outermost covering of the cell and it maintain the shape and protect the cell. Chloroplast is present only in the plants, is which is responsible for the production of food by itself during photosynthesis. So next one is large vacuole filled with both inorganic and organic molecules along with water to support the organelles. Yes, the next one, if you take this animal cell, yes, if you take the animal cell, centriole is present, and centriole is a pair of minute cylindrical involved in the development of spindle fibers in cell division. Small vacuole filled with both inorganic and organic molecules along with water to support the organelle. In plant cell, large vacuoles are present filled with both inorganic and organic molecules along with water to support the organelle. Here small vacuole is present which is filled with both inorganic and organic molecules along with water to support the organelle. So plant cell will have cell wall, animal cell do not have cell wall. Plant cell have chloroplast, animal cells do not have chloroplast. Clear children? The common things which are present in both are nucleus, ribosome, cytoplasm, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi body, mitochondria. Yes, we'll see one by one the function. Nucleus. So in eukaryotic cell alone, nucleus will be present. Prokaryotic cell do not have nucleus. So nucleus which are present in the eukaryotic cell is the control center of the cell. Yes, nucleus will control all the parts which are present inside the cell. It will control. It is the largest organelle. Next one is ribosome. Ribosome is a minute particle consisting of RNA. These synthesize polypeptides and proteins. The next one, cytoplasm. The cytoplasm includes all living parts of the cell within the cell membrane but excluding the nucleus. So if you take the cell structure, at the center nucleus will be present. Outside the nucleus, the space covered inside the cell, that is outside the nucleus, that place we call it as cytoplasm. Clear children? The next one, endoplasmic reticulum, we call that as ER. Endoplasmic reticulum is a network of membranous tubules and are involved in protein and lipid synthesis. The next one, Golgi body. Golgi body is a complex of vessels and folded membranes involved in secretion and intracellular transport. Then mitochondria. Mitochondria are organelles. They make most of the cell supply of adenosine triphosphate, that is ATP, a molecule that cells use an use as a source of energy. Yes, mitochondria is a powerhouse. We call that as a powerhouse. Each and every cell needs power or energy to do their particular work, isn't it? So we call this as the powerhouse. Mitochondria, we call that as a powerhouse. This which is responsible for it, this mitochondria's main job is to convert energy. Clear, children? With this, I'll stop this. Just you go through the pages which I have covered. If you are having any doubt, you can ask me. Well, okay, children, with this, I'll stop this lesson. Thank you.